I'm super excited about Windows 365, mm-hmm. particularly from an administration standpoint, right? If it takes a little longer for your employee to get their physical laptop, really all they need is a browser, and they can use any machine they have to be productive right away. That's so incredible. I love it.
That was actually really cool, because basically you go to the website and you have your machine, and maybe I don't want to carry a machine around. Maybe I want like a little lovely tablet device like this. Well, this is a full computer, but a little lovely tablet device to do my work, and I totally can. The other thing that was interesting was the Microsoft 365 that has the administration stuff. People might not know this, but for my family, I have one of those tenants, and I am the administrator of the Juarez family. Having all those new things in there was pretty cool. I liked it.
Yeah.
The administrator.
As the administrator, be sure to try it out and tell us what your favorite new feature is.
You got it.
All right, so now it's time to turn our attention to the cloud. Jeremy Winter, Director of Azure Management, joins the show via Teams. Jeremy, welcome. How are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
It's lovely to have you. Okay, let's go ahead and jump right in. So how has the customer mindset towards cloud adoption shifted over the last, say, 18 to 24 months?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the pandemic has really accelerated this shift to the cloud, Allison. And as customers just recover and look ahead to transforming how they run, they're turning to us wholesale for investments ranging from the remote productivity to infra resiliency to app innovation. And the cloud, I'll just tell you, in one shape or another, has become the primary bet in all the strategic conversations I'm having with business leaders, and we're seeing it with real absolute adoption.
Awesome. So tell me a little bit more about the main cloud adoption choices that our customers can take.
Yeah. You know, I'm seeing three main choices out there, or technical patterns to the journey, as we see. You know, and most of our bigger customers, Allison, adopt these patterns in parallel for different pieces of their estate. So the first one I'm seeing is migration. It's just really, how do we migrate those existing apps quickly? On the core IaaS front, we put in a lot of focus on infra resiliency with things like availability zones and DC region pairs, as well as tooling to simplify these moves. Like as an example, the American Cancer Society, they worked with us to exit their data center and over to Azure in less than 2 months. And it was pretty impressive just to see how fast they're able to do it. The second big area that I see is modernizing those existing apps with containers and managed databases. And wow, there's just a ton of momentum building on Kubernetes and where we're headed with the container space. And an example here is AIA Singapore, which is a financial planning firm that modernized their legacy Java to Azure Kubernetes service and the Azure SQL, which really they just used to speed up their point of sale applications across the board. And then this last shift that I see of these big choices that are helping drive is really this move to cloud native approaches through DevOps with GitHub and taking advantage of these serverless approaches, but also really the way you could think about your development environment. And you know, when you look at GitHub with more than 56 million strong developer community, we're just seeing GitHub and Azure DevOps enabling this super fast cycle.
Yeah, you know, as a product manager on Code Spaces, I couldn't agree with you more. We're really excited to leverage containers there. So why should customers select Microsoft and Azure over other offerings?
You know, one of the big things I see is just, I'll start with just the Microsoft cloud with the integration across Azure and Microsoft 365 and Dynamics 365. We're a partner across the entire business. Then on top of that, it's some of the innovation that we have that like our hybrid and multi-cloud flexibility with Azure Arc that's real and in market today. You know, we've enabled Azure-centric management and security from a control plane that can run in and across any environment. It's backed by Azure solutions like Azure Stack HCI and services like Azure Data and ML. But the cool thing is these are designed to run both on our cloud as well as at the edge. And of course, I see a lot around security and trust. I mean, I love the fact that we're a partner with our customers. We have their back with a ton of investments, including these just talented security experts we have protecting Azure's platform and a lot of the AI threat detection that's just built native in.
Yeah, I loved hearing about the Microsoft Defender and how we're enabling you to really be secure even in multi-cloud scenarios. So that's a great example of how we support our customers sort of where they're at. Are there any other ways that you'd like to share with us on how we support customers so they can move confidently?
For sure, Allison. I think we have programs like the Azure Migration and Modernization Program, or oftentimes you're going to hear us talk about it as AMP. This is really there to help guide our customers at each stage of their journey. And I just really encourage everyone to go leverage this with your partners, as well as reach out to us, and we'll get you connected in with that. We also provide tooling like Azure Migrate to automate every aspect of the move, so that you don't have to hunt and peck for what solution to use. It's just all there, simple for you on Azure.
Oh, I love it. So last question, any final comments for our IT friends who might be watching?
Yeah, IT friends, look, I'll end by saying that in addition to all this tech, don't forget the culture. That culture piece of the organization is key here. And my shout out to all the IT pros out there is you have just such a great opportunity to be the torch bearers and drive this cloud transformation within your company and the teams around you. So we're here to help you. Please, please make sure you reach out to us.
Amazing. Thank you so much for joining us, Jeremy.